I'd like to go over the syllabus for my classes for the spring of 2023. The one you see here is for Design 330. All of my syllabi are pretty much the same, with the only change being in the student learning outcomes and the topics. And I'll do a different video to show those for each of the classes. But let's just take a look and see what's in the syllabus. And how that works. One of the things that you should know is the syllabus is essentially sort of like a contract or a specification that says how the class is going to go and how we operate. So it's really important to understand the syllabus. You may hear me occasionally talking about some of my martial arts background and a very cool dude from the 1600s called Miyamoto Musashi, who was a great, great, great swordsman and eventually settled down to write a book on how to be really, really good at whatever it is that you want to do. And in it, he had nine rules. And they're very good general rules. If you're interested, I can post them. But rule number nine is very, very important. It was the last one. And it's paraphrased as do nothing that is useless. And I think that that's super important. And so the syllabus gives you the corollary of that. It tells you what is useful. To do nothing that is useless, you really need to know what is useful. And that's what the syllabus is for. So let's take a look at it and see what it's about. The first page is sort of a summary of what you'll see inside of it, the course description, details, student learning outcomes, the course calendars and the topics. That, of course, you're going to see in a separate video for each class. So we'll go over that very briefly. Grading and academic honesty. Students want to know how they get a good grade, and the college wants to make sure that you understand what academic honesty means because it's very important. Then we talk about participation. That's also very important for the class. Materials, supplies, and additional resources. And this is also important. If something's going wrong, how do you complain about it? Always need to know how to do that. Okay, so on this first page, you'll see some contact information about me. There's a little video over here that you can go to. And you can email me or use Canvas messages. This is my phone in the office on campus, and it sends a voicemail to my email. So if you want to leave me a voicemail, go ahead and do that. Sometimes that's the easiest thing to do. When you share files with me, share it using my W number at apps.losrios.edu. That's how I log in to the Google Drive. Okay, some people like to get a hold of me on Discord. It pops up very quickly and easily for me. I am a Discord user. So if you need to send me a direct message, you can do so. And then, of course, sometimes you just need to meet with me. And you can meet with me in my office during office hours if you're on campus, or if you want to make an appointment to meet with me online, you can use this calendar. Now, here's one. This is a good one. This is what people say about my classes. Okay, and so just know nothing is easy in my classes, but it is all useful. I try to follow Musashi's number nine, do nothing that is useless. And if you're interested in seeing what other students think about me, feel free to go to ratemyprofessor.com, and you're even welcome to put information in there too. Okay, so once you're done with a page, you'll see this in the assignments. You'll need to make that green. This is sort of like a contract, And you need to read it, and you need to certify to me that you've read and understood each page. So as you go through each page on your own, you'll go and make it green. You go to the little paint, you go and make it green, and that signifies to me that it's done. Now I'm going to undo that one, and I'm not going to demonstrate that anymore. The next page is what you're supposed to learn. So each class has their own description of the units, how long it's going to take, and prerequisites. Those are classes that you're supposed to have taken and passed in order to qualify for this class. Some of my courses have no prerequisites, and some do have some. And advisories mean that it's a good idea if you can do it. Then there's our official description and our official list of student learning outcomes. What a student will be able to do when they have completed the course. Okay, so those are listed for each class. And then there's just some notes on the class itself. Now, this is interesting. All of my classes, whether they be fully asynchronous or partly online or partly in class, may request to participate fully online. And that's either asynchronous or in Zoom. So if you're in one of my classes that has a lab time on campus, please know that you can participate online if you request and I approve. And just please note that I may rescind that if technical issues are hampering your success in student learning. Okay? So it's not open, just open, and you can do it. You need to make a request to me via email or Zoom, and I will approve it, but we'll keep an eye on it and make sure that it's working. So there's the course description, and then the next part has the calendar and the topics. There are 16 weeks. We have our spring break from March 13th to March 19th, and the final exam will be per the published dates on the ARC website. So, how do you get a grade in this class? So, now let's talk about this one. And this is the same for every single class that I teach in this spring. So, there's a little bit about your grade and a little bit about revisions. So, let's talk about your grade. Okay, first of all, everything that gets graded is submitted to the appropriate Canvas module for every file. Each week, things that are due are posted in Canvas. The due dates are posted in Canvas. And I can go back and show those to you, or you can go back and look at the Canvas thing that says shows when they're posted. Okay? Let's just take a look at one, maybe. Maybe I can find one over here just to show you. If we go to the grades, you'll see that the due dates are all posted in the grades. Those are due dates, and they're also posted in the modules. So there's two places to go to look for those. Okay, sometimes or often work is a progress check. Many assignments in all of my classes last more than 1 week, but part of it is due. Okay, now if you get some of that work done and then you make a final submittal later on that has a better grade than your progress check, I will go back and replace your progress check grade with the higher final submittal grade. Okay, so progress checks are exactly that. You do get a grade, and you get feedback. But if your final submittal goes and makes changes and updates and maybe completes some things that weren't done, then I will use your final submittal grade as its replacement. Okay, participation is important, whether it be in class or online. In class, meaning on campus. And they're critical. Being an active part of a team that can give feedback and discuss problems and discuss options well and clearly is a workplace norm that is teachable. And so we are going through teaching that. Okay, so there is a collaboration record that's downloaded each week, and that can be either items from a chat, it can be activities on a collaboration tool such as Jamboard or Navisworks or Bluebeam or a Google slide. But whatever our collaboration tool is, there is a record of what you've done, and I assign points after I download that each week and review your participation. So if it's asked for, it needs to be done. Some of the participation is time sensitive, and you will need to do that participation on time to receive points. This does make up a significant part of your grade each week. Okay, so there are files to submit. There is participation to do. And then those make up your final grade. Not your final grade. Your final grade. And that's the average of everything. Usually things count for 10 points. Just to make it easy on me to average them all, but it's not too hard. So you get an average of everything. Exam points count exactly the same as participation point, as a point in an assigned file. Okay, so every point has the same value as every other point. An A is 90% and up. A B is 80 to 89. Usually, if you're at an 89.5, I'll round up. 70 to 79, 60 to 69 for a D, and F is below 60. So now, how does that all work? If your work is on time and fully meets standards and requirements, you will get full credit. Okay? You meet the requirements. That is full credit on an assignment. If you've got something that has a revision or not full credit, okay, you can go back and fix them, okay, which you'll see in a moment. Sometimes it takes me 3 or 4 days after the due date, but generally it will be done. Grades and revision notes will be done on the Tuesday following the due date. Most due dates, not all, but most due dates are Sunday at 11:59 p.m. So that's how your grade works. Now let's talk about revisions. Rework and revisions are natural. They're common. They're an important part of the design and drawing process. You should get used to going back to your work and looking it over yourself to see if you can make it stronger. And you should certainly read feedback in your grades to see if there's anything that needs to be improved. Okay, then you go back and revise it. There is no penalty for revising work later on. Okay, no penalty at all. If you submitted it and I call for a revision, you can receive up to full credit. Now, every now and then, somebody returns in something that has so little work that it's not a revision and I'm just going to count it as late. I'll let you know in the comments. Okay, so rework is recommended and carries no penalty to your score. Late work is a little bit different. Turning in late work is poor practice. I've been on jobs where we're opening a bid and it's due at 10, the door slams closed at 10, and the clients open the bids. And I've been on jobs, million-dollar jobs, where a guy is running down the hall and did not make it in the door by 10 o'clock and they got locked out. Okay? And they would have won the bid. So late work is poor practice. It is far better to turn in incomplete work and revise it later. Okay? However, I do accept late work. It's better than no work. Okay, but there is a points penalty, and it gets greater and greater as the course progresses. Okay? The late penalty is indicated in the rubric. So being on time counts for, say, a point out of 10 at the beginning of the semester. And it counts as 2 points later in the semester. And it counts as 3 points. So on late work, you do not get those points back. Okay, so by the end of the semester, as you're starting to do it, you can get significantly penalized for late work. Right? So read the rubric. The rubric is how I grade. At the beginning of the semester, I'm getting people a chance to kind of figure things out and see how it works. But later on, I expect things to be on time. Okay, let's take a look now at academic honesty. First of all, there's a whole page, there's a whole video about it that I'll expect you to go and watch. Okay, you can also look it up on the ARC homepage under student responsibilities. Okay, but in general, honesty and integrity are what makes our discipline work. We rely on our designers, our architects, our engineers, our contractors to be honest and professional. And so academic honesty is where we start. Safety and reliability is number one. Our products, our designs have to be safe because people use them. Okay, and as a designer, you're going to be relied on to certify that your work does meet all relevant standards, regulations, and specifications for safety to the best of your knowledge. You have to do the absolute best that you can when you do these. And then you also need to meet the client's requirements as they've been given to you. Sometimes that's a very hard job to do. Safety is always more important than client requirements. Okay, so that's the basis of it. Okay, ARC faculty obligations. That's me, your professor, to our area's industry professionals. Those are the people that are going to hire you. Okay. They know that by giving you a passing grade or by granting you a certificate, we have trained you in integrity, professionalism, honesty, safety is number one, and the skills that are the basis for our professional standards. Okay, so now what does all of that mean? Okay, so number one, it means turn in only your own work and only work that truly and honestly represents your own skill, your ability, and the available time that you have personally to complete the work. Being rushed, having extra things to do, having some stresses, are no excuse for turning in somebody else's work as your own. Okay? If any of those other situations exist, please let me know so that I can accommodate your difficulties. And I will work to do that really hard. Okay? So just be honest and true and represent your skill well. Okay? Now, sometimes you'll need to collaborate. In some courses that I teach and some assignments, you'll need to work with somebody and you'll turn in your own work and they'll turn in their own work. And there will be a portion that will be turned in together that includes both of those. So you'll need to clearly identify which work was yours and which work was done by who you collaborated with. Okay? So, and that's part of just good standard industry practice. You sign your name to your stuff, other people sign their name to their stuff. You are encouraged to work together. Okay? You can get together in chat rooms or on campus or in tutorials or in the Learning Resource Center. Feel free to work together. Share your skills and your information, but only use your own files. Okay, you cannot use the mouse for somebody else. You cannot give them your file to copy or work off of. You can share your information, but not your files. Okay, so if I note that your work might be violating or going around this policy, I'll consult with you to see if you've made a false certification of your skill. You will, each week, certify that the work that you've turned in is truly and honestly your work. And so if I see that you've done a false certification, you'll get a zero on all work for that week until you redo it all without help. And that will be while I'm watching, which can be hard, okay? Or somebody else is watching, okay? This may be just an opportunity, though, to learn about professionalism, okay? But I may choose to go back and do a complete review of all of your work, okay? And if it indicates a repetitive problem or pattern, you may also get a reduction in your final grade by one letter grade, depending on the scope of the problem. Okay? The end all is follow academic honesty policies and professionalism. Okay? If it looks like something where you need additional information about the importance of this, I will most likely ask our dean, Gary Aguilar, who is a licensed architect, to discuss this with you. And there could be a referral to the Office of Student Conduct. And I'd like you to know that these consequences also apply to whoever assisted you. Okay? So it sounds draconian, but it's not. Do this, and you're fine. Do this, and you're fine. Okay, so that's a little bit about academic honesty. So let's talk about participation. Okay, in reality, I do what's called high flex. You can, for many of my courses that have an online component, of course, you do that online, but you can do it while I'm lecturing online or do it on your own time. A few courses I do are what's called asynchronous, where you just have to get in and work on it on your own, but you can always get ahead of me, get a hold of me, okay? So you can read through here. This is about high flex lecture and lab. If I'm available on campus, that is the best time to work with me, okay? For collaboration, okay, you are required to collaborate, even if you're doing it online, okay? And so I offer some online collaboration, and then progress checks, Okay, progress checks are important. They're done in the workplace. It's about accountability for delivering your assigned work. Okay, and I meet with people all the time. So I encourage you to do progress checks with me, either in lab or through my calendar. Okay, you can get a hold of me by email. And of course, professionalism, let's talk about that, especially in your participation. Okay, most workplaces have some sort of standards for professionalism. I'm no exception. So here's the gist of it. Treat your instructor and all your colleagues in a professional manner. That means communicate in a way which is polite and civil. Even if you happen to have a great difference of opinion. Okay? And then make every effort to present yourself in a professional, well-dressed, well-groomed manner whenever you are participating. Okay? Now, what that means, professional, it doesn't mean you have to wear a tie. Really, professional means attentive. When somebody's speaking, pay attention to them. Make sure that they understand that you're paying attention and that you're thinking and listening and accepting, not agreeing with, accepting, letting it sink in what they are going over and what they're saying. So that's a little bit about participation. Materials, supplies, additional resources. We're a zero textbook cost class. All of my classes are. You have no textbooks that are required. Supplies, zero textbook cost class also means you do not need to purchase any supplies. And here are some additional resources. Now, we have some students that have special needs. Sometimes it's formal and sometimes it's not. So please make sure that I've got all of your documentation if you have special needs. And if you don't have documentation on it, but do believe you have some special needs that I need to address as your professor, please let me know before it's a problem. Please let me know early on. Okay, so, and finally, how do you make a complaint? Some things use a very simple process. Those are things like, oh, you need some information about a grade or need me to grade something. You need extra time or help, or maybe you need to know what to take next semester, or you need a letter of reference. Send me an email, wait for a day or two, and then once I respond, make sure that I've actually addressed your concern. If I haven't, go back and do this all again. Okay. However, sometimes it's maybe a bigger deal and you don't want to talk with me. Maybe I am the problem. You need to talk with somebody else. You can contact our dean. His name is Gary Aguilar. He's our division dean. Okay. And so you do that if you're not comfortable bringing the issue up with your professor. Okay. Or whatever response I gave you, you just don't like it. It's like, no. You think it should be a different response. So the same thing, wait for a day or two. He's got, you know, hundreds and hundreds of students to be responsible for and do it there. Okay? And then you'll see in the assignments that there are some questions to do. So there we go. That is an overview of the syllabus. Please review this and let me know if you have any questions. And as part of your assignment, you will see that these will all need to be turned green and that this needs to be